Welcome everyone to the first Funday Sunday of 2021 at BAA Bel Art Attractions. Hope you've got your coffees on, or your cup of teas, or your water, whatever, and are ready to join us on our little chilled podcast-y type session. We've also got a couple of events that we'd like to share with you for the coming week. I'm Bojana. This is our director of Noni and Milica. So what we'd like you to do is follow us, subscribe, hit that subscribe notification bell so you know when we've got new videos out. And also you can contact us on Milica if you'd like to do the pleasure.
Yes, of course. So friends, if you want to talk to us, if you have any interesting ideas, if you have any suggestions for us, if you just want to chat, you can hit us up at the email bellartattractions@gmail.com. And of course, we would like you to stay for discussion. So first of all, we're going to introduce the fun events that we have prepared for you. And then we're going to discuss some fun topics. So stay tuned.
So let's go. So skipping to this week on Friday, 22nd of January, stand-up comedian stroke poet Miodrag Stošić will be holding a poetry evening at Bluz, Pivo, which is on Cetinjska 15 in Dorčol. So Miodrag Stošić, he's going to be performing his views about the previous goings-on of previous years, as well as some parts from his book, Miss Mokre Oči, Miss Wet Eyes. He will also talk about his first published book, Kako sam smršao 60 kila bez tašte I heroina. So that's translated as the book, How I Lost 60 Kilos Without My Mother-in-Law and Heroin. Tickets are 200 dinars, so really, really cheap. But space, of course, is limited, as with most events going on at this time. The space is limited to 35 people, so get your seat now. It starts at 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. And at the end, you can buy some of his books, which he'll be really happy to sign for you. The event will be in Serbian, so it's a good one if you want to go brush up your language. So we'll see you there.
Yes, and going on further, so something else that is also happening this next Friday on the 22nd of January is a very interesting play called Dragi Tata or Dear Dad. So it's a play done by Theater 011 or Teatr 011, and it will be held at Akademija 28, so at Nemanjina 28 at 7 p.m. Tickets are 500 dinars, so I think that's a very reasonable price. And the story is very interesting. It's a sort of a Serbian classic story about growing up that looks at the decline of the middle class. So it's all about the collapse of all the value systems in our society in Serbia and the Balkans in the 90s. And it tells a story of a childhood of a young girl. It's written by Minja Bogavac. Personally, I've read it and my mind was blown away. It's a very interesting story about society, the absence of authority, the destruction of the family, and sort of the possibility of a saving place called home from the street. And this piece in which the streets enter the house, it crosses it, it paves it, and it irons it. And I think it's a must-see for everyone that either was a teenager, is a teenager, or raises a teenager. Links are below for all the events.
Sounds really positive, doesn't it? No, I'm only joking.
Yeah, sounds a bit gloomy, but when I read it, I felt kind of understood. You know, it says a lot about growing up in Serbia.
I think this is great now, then, you know, from this event to move on to our discussion, if you'd like to lead us in, Milica.
Yes, of course. So, you know, that I mentioned that this is a work of Minja Bogavac, and she's our Serbian writer and theater director. And I think she's a really amazing author. And while we're at it, I wanted to ask you girls and to discuss about what would it be like for you to meet your favorite author? So would they be as you have imagined or a bit different? Do you even imagine how they would act like, how they would present themselves? And I also wanted to ask you if you think that there is a slight change in the behavior of authors when they're writing, so that they are different when they write. So those are some interesting questions that we could, you know, like share, discuss.
Very interesting. I mean, what first came to mind for me is that it can be a dangerous thing meeting people you admire, getting to know people you admire, because invariably there's going to be a side to them that you're not going to quite like. And I think with writers especially, just like actors themselves, they have the ability to embody other characters or to kind of get into the psychology of other characters. And sometimes you don't know, is it a part of themselves that, you know, that they're actually bringing out, or, you know, or do they just have really, really good observational skills and they're able to, then they have empathy and they're able to understand the other person. But I'm thinking my favorite authors are dead. So, I mean, I wouldn't be able to meet them now. But from what I've researched, for example, Roald Dahl, he is my favorite author. I think, you know, obviously he's known worldwide and, you know, we've, most of us watched his movies or read his books growing up. And he definitely has a dark side. And I did a bit of research about him before we started this discussion. And it just so happens that, you know, it was 50-50. People either loved him or they found him really rude. And I can see how that could come across in his books, because his dark characters are really mean, but it's almost like he's discovering that part of himself through them. So anyway, I'll stop talking now. Let somebody else have a chance to.
No, it's,
I don't
it's
know, director.
Because I have read his books too, and I also bought some of his books for my little sister. And I think there's quite a different feeling if you read him as a kid and if you read him as an adult. Because if you're a kid, you're like, oh, the mean characters are mean and the good ones are good, and you just enjoy the work. And when you're a grown-up, you're like, what does he mean? What's his deal? You know, he seems like a very interesting sort of person, so. But yeah. I definitely agree with you.
Well, he was a war hero and he was a spy, and he obviously had a very, very interesting life. But what I like about his work is that that dark quality and that disgusting quality that he you know adds into his stories, you know, all kids love that, and it's kind of he always places them as a hero of his stories. And I think it's, you know, it reminds us also that there are kids growing up with adults that are, you know, that are, I mean, it's unfortunate, you know, that aren't treating them right, or, you know, teachers that are psychopaths. And, you know, it kind of gives the children, you know, a feeling of that they can be a hero too. They can, the sense of autonomy, that they can defend themselves and they can come out the heroes in the end, even though they're small. And you know, yes, they're kids, and that's what I like about him.
I think he has very multidimensional characters, you know, because sometimes in kids' books you just, you know, you see characters that are one-sized and not so complex and you know, good and nice, and then you read his books and you're like, oh, those are layered people, you know, they're not just kids or kids that are good or kids that are bad. You can see persons, people.
Yes.
I wanted to say is that I pretty much agree with you that it's very dangerous to meet your favorite authors, but yes, some of mine are dead too, so that's pretty impossible. But I think, you know, I think the best way to meet your favorite authors is just to go into it without expectations. Because recently I had an opportunity to meet some of the actors that I admired and some of the directors. And I thought, okay, I have very high expectations, but I'm not going to think about them. And I went in and I was so shy and I was so overwhelmed, but it felt amazing because I went in, okay, not expecting anything. I just know that I admire them. I like their work. I love their work. It's inspiring. And I talked to them like, you know, one-on-one. Like, they're also a person, and it was astonishing.
Well, when this is over, I'd like you to name drop.
Of course, of course. I'm not going to
name drop now. I'm going to name drop about my favorite authors right now. So I really like the work of Olja Savićević. Oh God, what's with my Serbian now?
Savić Ivančević. So she's amazing. She's a creation author and she writes short stories. She writes novels. And I accidentally came, acquainted with her novel, Nasmijeti psa. It was on Belgrade Book Fair. And I thought, okay, looks fun. And I have that weird quality, you know, everyone criticizes it, but if I see a nice book cover, I'm like, okay, reading the back page, buying it. And I bought it, based on how it looked like, how it seemed to me that it's interesting and light. And I was mistaken. It was interesting, but it wasn't light whatsoever. And she amazed me with her writing qualities, with the lightness of her style, with the way it's so easy to read and recognize yourself. But then when you think about the stories, you're like, oh, there are very dark elements here. And
did you meet her? Did you meet her or do you know what she maybe like as a person?
No, unfortunately not, but her name came to my mind when we thought, okay, favorite authors and meeting them, because, you know, most of my other favorite authors are dead or very, very old. So like Gabriel Garcia Marquez, no way to meet him. And also Nabokov, no way to meet him. And then I thought her, and I also like Lana Bastasic.
Mm-hmm.
She's very like, I think people talk a lot about her work right now. And I think it's a very positive example of a young female author, you know, being represented for her work and for all the right reasons.
I like that you're putting in the Serbian authors as well, that I haven't really had much of I have had opportunities, but I haven't really read as much as I should. So yes, I'm glad that you're showcasing them now.
She's a Bosnian woman, but I think, you know, it's all Balkans, and I like the feeling that when you read books from Croatian and Bosnian authors, you don't feel that divide.
Yeah. I didn't even notice it. But director, what did you have a favorite author that you want to talk about?
Well, I like the work of Ted Williams. He did like a Bobby Dollar series. The detective angel urban fantasy type of thing. I also like Waldo. I actually recently read his collection of short stories in Madness, which is for more adult orientated stuff. I think Milica said, like, don't have expectations when you meet your authors, and I also think it also depends like their mood and what time you meet them. Because usually when people meet authors, they're at book signings and it's like end of the day and they're tired and they've been signing books and have been like answering questions that have been like repeated a few too many times. And so I don't think that like they say don't meet your heroes, but I also think it depends on their mood. Like if they're in a good mood, then you're gonna have a good experience. If they're in a bad mood, which happens if you're tired, then you're gonna have a bad experience. If that
makes sense. You're absolutely right. If you look at it from a personal perspective, I mean, we're not always on top, you know, of ourselves. And of course we have sides that aren't particularly pleasant, I'm sure. One author that I was looking at, but I wasn't able to find as much personal information on him, was J.R.R. Tolkien, you know, of Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit series. And, you know, I wanted to kind of find out what people thought about him in general, but I just could find, you know, biographical things. But I know that one of his closest confidants and best friends was C.S. Lewis, and that they shared a lot of, interests. And, you know, and his interests also were, you know, he had a huge interest in mythology, one of which is Slavic mythology. And you can tell in the certain names that he's given characters, you know, for example, Boromir, you know, he sounds like a Serbian dude, doesn't he? So I would have liked to have met him. And, I love people like that are, you know, history buffs, or, you know, that they've got some sort of interest that maybe sort of, you know, look a bit kind of fantastical to the academic world, but, you know, without their imagination, you know, we wouldn't have these amazing stories that we all really connect with. So yeah, I think it's definitely an interesting topic. I'd like to hear from people if they've ever met an author or a famous person that was the complete opposite of their expectations and that changed their minds about their work.
I think, you know, I think it's funny for me because sometimes you have that situation. I'm giving, you know, example now, which maybe is not so good, but you know that feeling when you're walking down the street going home and you feel absolutely tired, washed out, exhausted, and your neighbor wants to talk and you're just like, like they're a paparazzi. And then I imagine, you know, all the famous authors, and not only authors but celebrities. I think, you know, the feeling of constantly being approached and asked, you know, various questions, some of which are, what does your work mean? Where did you get the inspiration for it? And I think, okay, I understand. I have a lot of questions for my favorite authors, but on the other hand, I would go insane. And maybe, just maybe, I would also be very rude if someone, you know, stepped on my bad side or met me at a bad day.
Yeah, or accosted you when you're going home and you're looking like you've been dragged through a hedge.
Yes.
And kind of like meeting your crush when you're looking, yes, you know, greasy and you've got 10 zits on your face.
Oh, thank you, God.
And you're getting all dressed up and not being anyone.
You know, like securely. Now I don't worry about it. But I wanted to say, I read it today. I don't know if you girls have heard about it. There was a story about Picasso, and a lot of people always ask him about the meaning of his work. And he got so sick of it that he got a gun and filled it with fake bullets, so the rubber ones. And every time someone asked him about the meaning, he shot them with the rubber bullets. And I thought, okay.
Ooh, that then, is very extreme, gee.
Yes, and I read it and I was like, whoa. Imagine that happening.
Yeah, well, I don't know if I'm gonna meet any of my favorite, well, I'm not gonna meet my favorite authors, obviously, anytime soon, but maybe favorite actors or whatever. But yeah, I think this is, do you guys wanna add anything else to this discussion, or should we leave it to our lovely viewers to add their comments?
Yeah, let's leave it to the viewers. So if you guys have a favorite author or anything, just comment below. I was pointing down to the comments, not to Milica. Milica, yeah. Point down.
Oh, I'm pointing. Comment Milica.
Yeah, comment on Milica's face.
Okay, guys. Well, it's been lovely chatting with you all. Well, chatting with you three, and hopefully with more of you in the comments. Again, please feel free to share your thoughts about what we've discussed today, and subscribe to us, like us, hit that notification bell, and the links to the events are down here in the description. So, you know, if you can be bothered to listen to us, that's it. Just go straight to the events and click on the links.
And just not to forget, you can always send us an email at bellartattractions@gmail.com. And I would also like to thank, you know, our director and Bojana for having this wonderful conversation. And we're very curious to hear your opinion, because this topic was so interesting that, you know, I just couldn't stop talking. And I can imagine how it is for someone who hears it, you know, for the first time, like, oh, I didn't think about it. So we're very interested to hear what you guys think.
Okay, guys, well, we'll see you next week on our next Funday Sunday. This has been the three of us here at BAA Bel Art Attractions. Bye.
Bye. Bye.